Hey, yo.
Let's go.
Turn your radio up.
It's going down.
You understand that?
You're listening to the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
I am happy to be on with you today.
Your weekly dose of news, lifestyle, arts, and culture that informs, empowers, and inspires.
This was the time when we came together. God bless you.
The Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Peace and love, world. How you doing out there? I'm Neil, and I am the lead anchor for the Urban Post Worldwide Weekly Newscast right here on www.rmconair.com. Now, it's the first show in the new year, so I'm saying Happy New Year to you, and we have a full show. Yesterday, we came off of Dr. Martin Luther King's celebration and the inauguration of President Barack Obama. It was a fabulous day. A lot of historical and memories about the civil rights movement that you just could not ignore. And so we're going to talk about that. Jehmu Greene, former executive director of Rock the Vote, is going to call in. She's still in D.C. She's going to tell us about all the activities. Plus, we're going to talk about what's next, what the Republicans plan on doing, because, you know, she's a contributor for Fox News, so she gets banged up a lot. She's calling in right now. So we're going to jump into a song. It's the new one from Justin Timberlake along with Jay-Z, and it's produced by Timberland. Check it out. It's called Suits and Ties. You're tuned in to the Urban Post Worldwide Weekly Newscast on www.rmconair.com.
Ready, JT?
I can't wait till I get you on the floor, good looking. Hey, going hot, so hot, just like an oven. And I'll burn myself, but just had to touch it. But it's so fine, and it's all mine. Hey, baby, we don't mind all the watching. Hi, cause if they study close, real close, they might learn something. And as long as I got my suit and tie, I won't leave it all on the floor tonight. And you got fixed up to the nines, let me show you a good thing. All pressed up in black and white, and you're dressed in that dress I like. Love is swinging in the air tonight, let me show you a good thing. Let me show you a good thing. Show you a good thing. So if I love, now we're in the swing of love, let me show you a good thing. Let me get a good look at it. Ooh, so thick. Now I know why they call it a fatty. And oh, shit, so sick. Got a hit and picked up a habit. That's alright, cause you're all mine. Oh, go on, show them who you call daddy. I guess they're just my cause, girl, they wish they had it. A classic, and you're all mine tonight. And as long as I got my suit and tie, I'ma leave it all on the floor tonight. And you got fixed up to the nines, let me show you a good thing. All pressed up in black and white, and you're dressed in that dress I like. Love is swinging in the air tonight, let me show you a good thing. Let me show you a good thing.
Get out your seat, Hov.
All black at the white shows.
White shoes at the black shows. Green car for the Cuban links. Y'all sit back and enjoy the light show. Nothing exceeds like excess. Style guy, gal from having the best of the best. Is this what it's all about? I'm at the rest. The rump, my rent, disturbing the guests. Years of distress, tears on the dress. Try to hide a face with some makeup sex. This is trouble season. Time for tuxedos for no reason. All saints for my angel. Alexander Wang too. Ass tight denim and some dunks. I show you how to do this, young. No papers, catch papers, get high. Out Vegas, Sousa's on doubles, ain't looking for trouble. You just got good genes, so a nigga tryna cuff you. Tell your mother that I love her, cause I love you. Tell your father we go father as a couple. They ain't lose a daughter, got a son. I show you how to do this, huh?
As long as I got my suit and tie, I'ma leave it all on the floor tonight. Baby got fixed up to the nines. Let me show you a few things. All dressed up in black and white, and you're dressed in that dress I like. Love is swinging in the air tonight. Let me show you a few things. Let me show you a few things. Show you a few things about love. Love, love. Let me show you a few things. Show you a few things about love.
You're listening to the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Yo, check it out. Check it out. Check it out.
Check it out.
With your host, Niel.
Flyest mommy on the radio.
And her crew.
Turn up your radio.
Welcome back. That was Justin Timberlake and Jay-Z, produced by Timberland. It's called Suit and Tie. New music from Justin. We like it here at the Urban Post. Yesterday was the inauguration. There were still some activities happening today. And tonight is the White House Staff's Ball. And I heard Lady Gaga's performing. So that's happening tonight. And I think after that, it'll be back to business as usual. But joining us right now is the former executive director of Rock the Vote. She's a political analyst for CNN, CNBC, and Fox News, Ms. Jehmu Greene. Welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me, Neil.
You're welcome. Are you rested from all the activities?
I'm not rested yet. I'm actually not done yet. I'm sitting a block away from the Washington Convention Center, about to enter into that White House staff ball. Well, actually, it's a Obama for America staff ball. All of the young women and men from around the country who helped re-elect President Obama are going to get a chance to not just hear Lady Gaga, but also hear from the president. It should be an amazing night.
Okay, and so you have participated in a lot of the inaugural festivities that have been going on. What have been some of the highlights for you?
It has just been an amazing set of days. I think, like most of the almost 800,000 people who witnessed the swearing in, that was absolutely the highlight. His speech really laying out what the next 4 years will look like in his agenda, really recommitting to legislation and leading from the office of the presidency to make sure that all of the great things that this country has to offer in our pursuit of life and liberty is not just for a few, but for all Americans. And I think, I mean, he recommitted to that, whether it is on immigration reform, whether it is making sure that our children are safe in their schools and in the streets, and refocusing on preventing gun violence, making sure that we extend all of the civil rights that, you know, were extended after the founding of our country to African Americans and to women, that those also are extended to gays and lesbians. His next 4 years laid out in that speech, and watching him get re-sworn in was, I think, for sure the highlight.
All right. So now you talked about the ball tonight, and David Palouf, who was instrumental in the whole Obama brand, spoke about how the president realized in the first term that no matter how hard he tries, there was a missing piece, and that was the activism from the American people. And so now tonight at this ball, you mentioned the staff, and they're moving into a transition to organizing for America, to organizing for action. Can you tell us how important that's going to be in the second term for President Obama?
It's going to be critical, Neil. When you look at what happened after he was first elected in 2008, we went into, you know, clearly a very hard economic crisis, many Americans losing their jobs, hundreds of thousands, millions of Americans losing their jobs within the first few months of the president's term, which I think, of course, made it harder for that activism and energy from the campaign to continue when people are just trying to focus on how are they going to pay their bills and, you know, make sure that they have food on the table and shelter for their family. But also what ended up happening after the Health Care Act passed was we saw the rise of the Tea Party and the midterm elections in 2010 mm-hmm. really, you know, changed the opportunity for the president to get as much as he wanted of his agenda accomplished. And it was the activism from the Tea Party that really did stop that agenda and helped the Republicans in Congress block his agenda. Hmm. So it's going to take the activism from all of the Americans who put him into office for a second time, that they need to be just as loud, they need to be just as involved as they were in getting him elected, to make sure we don't see a repeat of that in 2014, that these next 4 years he has the ground troops, he has the will of the American people behind that agenda that he laid out so eloquently yesterday. And I think the American people are ready to do that. I think they've seen our government come to a halt and really be broken and fractured by the activism of the Tea Party, and they're ready to push back. So organizing for action, moving into continuing the president's agenda on a daily basis, a legislative basis, is what is so critical to making sure that we continue to recover economically, but we also extend all of those rights that the president talked about. And one of them that I know that we share since we spent some time together at Rock the Vote, Neil, is voting rights. And so I was particularly pleased to hear him talk about the need for voting reforms and not having people wait in lines for 10 hours to mm-hmm. cast a ballot for their elected officials.
So true, so true. So where do you think this leaves the Republicans? What do you think their challenge is going to be?
The Republicans are facing a lot of challenges right now. They have to look inwardly into their party and figure out if they're going to continue to allow the extreme right and the Tea Party leadership that has come into Washington and said that it's their agenda to break government. We have a senator from Texas, Ted Cruz, who came in running on a campaign that said he wasn't going to compromise. And the Republicans are going to have to decide if that's the direction they want to go in, which I think would be to their detriment and would definitely help Democrats. And I'm a lifelong Democrat, so I'm not trying to help make the Republican Party better in a sense. But, I mean, they have to decide how they're going to move forward, if they want to continue to be the party of no, or if they want to live up to what they are elected to do. Regardless of if you are a Democrat or a Republican, they are elected to legislate. Mm-hmm. And they've been doing nothing but blocking. And hopefully we'll see some new leadership say enough is enough. We there has to be a different path, where compromise is a critical part of governing.
All right, and last question before you go off to the ball. Now, there's a lot of talk after yesterday how Vice President Biden was looking presidential and making some presidential comments, and then you always have the oh-so-lovely Hillary Clinton. Do you think that they're both going to go for a run in 2016?
It's hard to say now. You know, Vice President Biden, he sometimes gets ahead of himself with his words. And,
yes.
You know, he referred to himself as the president one of his remarks, which, of course, was just another gaffe that we have come to expect and love from him. I, of course, would love to see Hillary Clinton make a run in 2016. But I take her at her word that she has no plans to do that right now. I do think that when her country has called on her, she has always stepped in to provide whatever voice and leadership that she can to contribute. And so I'm hoping that her country will be able to convince her change her mind.
Yes. So we want to thank you for calling in, and you're probably going to the most important ball of them all, because I think tonight you guys are going to get some marching orders and expectations on how to lead us. So we want you to call back in. Thanks for calling in, Jehmu. I always say this. I think it's because of you that I began to love politics the way that I do, and you really taught me a lot about the political game. So I just want to say thank you.
Well, you're quite welcome, Neil, and you have taught me so much about being passionate about what you believe in and following your dream, and as long as you keep working at it, that you're going to be able to succeed, and I am inspired by you.
Oh, okay, great. So then we're going to talk to Jehmu, and then next time we're Skyping now, so I want you to Skype in the next time. Have fun
Fantastic.
Tonight. All right, have fun tonight, and have a toast for me. Think about me when you toast tonight.
I will absolutely toast to you.
All right.
Have a good night.
You too. Coming up, when we're talking about organizing for action, it's all about the power of one, how one voice can make change and can engage a community, can engage a neighborhood, and can engage Facebook to help create change. So we have some organizations or some petitions that have happened over the past couple of weeks that have won victory in the press because of the action of one. So while you're thinking about that, listen to the lyrics. This is Israel Houghton with The Power of One, powerful lyrics and great testimony. You're tuned in to the Urban Pulse Worldwide Weekly Newscast on www.rmconair.com.
Sit down and believe we can.
To the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
I am happy to be on with you today.
Your weekly dose of news, lifestyle arts, and culture that informs, empowers, and inspires.
This was the time when we came together. God bless you. God bless the United States of America.
The Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Worldwide Radio.
Welcome back to the show. The time is 3:30 Pacific Standard Time. Hello, world. That was The Power of One by Israel Houghton. And that's what we're talking about. We just re-inaugurated President Barack Obama, who decided to run for president, one person, and he was able to galvanize a nation to make him president, the first black president of the United States. And I'm saying that because the power of one is so powerful, especially when you have a purpose and your heart's in it. So a few things have happened over the holidays and over the past few weeks that I thought that we should talk about. So we have some fabulous guests in here who, with the power of one, they joined with the hands of many and they were able to make change. And so joining us right now, I have Tenaya Jackson. Welcome
Hello.
To the show. CC Counts.
Hello.
And Reverend K.W. Tulloss.
Glad to be here.
Glad to be here. Now, Reverend K.W. Tulloss is from the president of the L.A. chapter of the National Action Network, which is an affiliation and extension of Reverend Al Sharpton's national network. And he is also the pastor of
Weller Street Missionary Baptist Church
yes.
in the city of L.A.
And so, Django. Great movie. I loved it. Have to say that. I'm sorry. I love the movie. But there were some things that disturbed the African-American community. And Reverend K.W. Tulloss got together with community activist Naji Ali, and Tenaya got involved. Tenaya, how did you get involved? Now, I know why Naji and Reverend Tulloss, you know, was on it. But how did you become affiliated with this movement?
Well, I just was offended. I did not see the movie, and this is one of those films that I just did not see. But I did not just... It just didn't sit well with me, mm-hmm. you know, as far as how it was done. How it was packaged, I mean, meaning
you're talking
how it was
about
presented.
The dolls, right?
Yes, okay. The slave dolls. That is definitely something that I felt like just, it was over the top. Mm-hmm. And I brought in my inspiration, which is my great-grandmother. Her mom was a slave.
Put it up to the camera so they can see that.
This is my grandma, my uh-huh. great-grandma. Uh-huh. And unfortunately, her mother was born into slavery. And I'm a person, many people know me for many different things, promoting parties and all that stuff. But it's kind of like another part to me that is very, you know, I feel just deeply about our people mm-hmm. and the growth and prosperity of us and how we present ourselves and how we, you know, come across the people so we could be able to, you know, move further, you know? Mm-hmm. And it just didn't feel right, you know what I mean? So I just, you know, I just went on and said, I'm about to do this.
And so you saw the petition on Facebook or something?
Well, no, I started the petition.
Oh, you started the petition.
I'm the one
okay.
who started the
power
petition.
Of one. Now, see, I would have thought that Naji Ali and Reverend Tulloss had picked up this burden and carried it, but it was you.
It was me.
The power of one. I'm telling you guys, change can happen. So, Reverend Tulloss, how did you become involved?
How we got involved was, you know, from the petition that Tenaya placed up. Naji Ali, he contacted my office and said, have you seen this slave doll? And I said, no, I haven't saw it, and went online and looked at the doll, and I'm like Tenaya, was like very offended by what I was seeing. I have not as of yet saw the Django. But I hear
it's Django.
Django.
I say the Django too. That's
Django.
Another
excuse me. Excuse
Quentin Tarantino
exactly.
Little joke.
I haven't seen Django, and you know, I was offended by the doll, and so we decided to push out a statement in reference to the doll, basically asking the doll to be pushed, taken down. We sent out a press release. Mm-hmm. We had a press conference in the Leimert Park area, very well attended. CNN got national coverage. New York Times, New York Daily News got national coverage, and it just caught fire after that. But I want to thank you for your efforts and bringing awareness. And we thank you so much for letting the people know about what was happening in the community. But it was the power of one that started this fire.
Mm-hmm. And it was all because the memory of your great-grandmother.
Yes.
And I can definitely respect that. And I can see how the dolls are offensive. But it was a great movie.
Mm-hmm.
And the what I loved about it is because in slavery, you always hear the burden and the hardship. Mm-hmm. This time, you had a slave that was empowered, an ex-slave that was empowered, and that... it was like a Cinderella story because mm-hmm. he went and got his Broomhilda.
Yeah.
So it was just so many levels. I thought it was a great film. But nobody can understand the pain of certain things unless you walked in those shoes.
Yeah.
So I totally respect what you done. I just did not know today it was you. So congratulations on that. The
Thank
power
you.
Of one.
Thank you.
That's what we're talking about today. The power of one and how Tenaya Jackson... So I did a petition to get the Django slave dolls taken out of the stores. Two very prominent community activists here in LA saw what she was doing, and they used their power to support her, and she was able to make change. So you can do, no matter what's happening in your neighborhood or your community, you have the power to make change. Another person joining us is Cece Counts. Hey, Cece, we're having a beat reunion.
Hello, I know, right?
Now, tell us a little bit about what got you stirred on Facebook.
Well, we've all been on Facebook and seen, you know, a lot of graphic videos pop up here and there, pornography videos. And of course, that's already upsetting. And it's related to hackers. They go in and hack people's pages and put up these videos. And they come down pretty quickly. But I came across a video that I thought was something else, and I clicked on it. And at first, it was a torn thing where I regretted doing it, but it pushed me into something else. But it happened to be a child pornography video. Mm. And it was a toddler who maybe three at the most.
Male or female?
Male. Mm-hmm. And he was simulating sex with an adult female. Mm. And I didn't get through the whole thing because it was so shocking. Mm-hmm. But it stirred me so much that I was sick all night. But I was so shocked, I don't think I knew how to react, because you know this is happening in the world. You're very aware of it. You see it on TV all the time, whether it's, you know, on 20, 60, you know, minutes, or mm-hmm. the news, or even TV shows, you know, they have this subject on. But I think when you're face to face with it, the reality just hits you in a totally different way. So, yeah, I was just so sick the next morning that, you know, I just wrote on Facebook about the incident. I went to go try to see if the link was still there, but it was taken off. I'm sure that the people that were that put it up weren't the actual person that the page belonged to. Mm-hmm. And I was outraged, and I just got a lot of feedback. It kind of stirred up a lot, and I was able to find a link to a program. It's actually a website, and it's called the Association of Sites Advocating Child Protection. Now, this website, I shared the link online on Facebook, and I think that it's helped a lot of parents. I didn't even know that something like this as far, you know, existed, but it's ASACP.org. That's ASACP.org. And this website kind of gives you a rundown of different ways to protect your children. And it'll give you software to, you know, put onto your computer to help predators keep away from your children. Mm-hmm. And it also gives you signs and signals of what you can look for in people. And it also, you can go on there and report anything that you see online. Because if I can just click on one thing and find something that easily, I'm sure that there's just so many other things hidden within links. Mm-hmm. And the one thing that I wish I would have done, because I was so shocked, is report it right away. But I don't think that I mentally was
prepared. It caught you off guard. Uh-huh.
So what I wanted to do is to prepare people. For one, this does happen. You already have the answer. It's there for you. The information is there. And you don't make the same mistake that I made.
I thought what's interesting was some of the comments that you saw men make.
Yeah, it was the other thing that was really disturbing is, obviously, I don't think the person posted it, but some of his friends actually commented on the link, and it was males that were, it's disgusting to even think about, were cheering this toddler on, saying stuff like he's going to be a pimp by the time he's 12, you know, how many children, you know, he's probably going to have, and, you know, go ahead, and kind of cheering him on. And that really kind of turned my stomach too, because if they're so easily to write a comment like that on Facebook and let everybody know that, it could be the person sitting next to you that is molesting a child. Mm-hmm. If they think that this is okay, then that you know, might just be the person that is doing it. Mm-hmm. Especially so openly. So it just really lit a fire under me. I mean, I hate to live in a life of fear and constantly looking at people in a suspected way, but mm-hmm. I think that people should be very aware. And I think if you're aware and educated about the situation, it just will help you if it were to ever arise.
Yeah. So, and we're on Facebook all the time and always run across pornography. Just put it out there, you know, whether it's adult pornography, right. You know, you run across it. So thank you for finding that website. And the website again is www.asacp.org. We're talking about the power of one and how the power of one joined with many's, and the many could be your church, the many could be your community, your neighborhood, the many could be your local elected official, the many could be anybody, but just have the passion to be concerned about your fellow neighbor. We're going to take a quick break, and when we come back, Mo Kelly, I know you guys heard about this one. All My Baby's Mamas, y'all heard about that one?
Yeah. Yes.
It was the rapper Shoddy Low. actually, he got arrested yesterday for something, some baby mama stuff. But he was going to have a show on Oxygen, and Mo Kelly's going to tell us how he stopped that. You're tuned in to the Urban Post Worldwide Weekly Newscast on www.rmconair, and here's Bruno Mars with Knocked Out of Heaven. Locked Out of Heaven.
Swimming in your water, so You're listening to the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Yo, check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
With your host, Niel.
Your host, Niel.
And her crew.
Turn up your radio.
Welcome back to the show. That was Bruno Mars with Locked Out of Heaven. And we're still talking about not the vapors, but we're talking about the power of one. But during the Bruno Mars song, we got into a conversation. So I told you we were having a beat reunion. And when I say beat, I'm talking about Los Angeles.
You're right.
The poetess right now is going to join the conversation. Hey, poetess.
I'm off camera, but during the break, I posed the question, what's wrong with the dolls? I mean, why would we spend our energy protesting that when we have bigger fish to fry? That's where I stand on that whole issue.
Now, if you're just tuning in, as I said, we're talking about the power of one, and Tenaya Jackson was very offended by the Jenga slave dolls that were being sold. The movie was a hit, and in turn, they created these dolls of the different slaves and the slave masters. They began selling them, and Tenaya got very offended by it, and the National Action Network got involved, community activist Najee Ali got involved, and now the dolls have been pulled from the shelves. But Porter's question is, once again, tell us, Porter's.
I'm not easily offended by stuff. I see where people may be upset about the dolls, but you can also use those dolls as a teaching tool as well. I mean, it's all on perspective and how you look at it, but I don't have a problem with the dolls. That's where I stand on it, and I'm probably going to get some hate mail or some nasty comments, but that's how I look at it.
Who wants to respond?
You want to go first?
Well, my, you know, the poetess, her statement is valid, because we received a lot of questions of why, well, isn't there bigger things to worry about? But again, here it is. We have a doll that was highly offensive to slavery and to our ancestors. Here it is. We have a doll that, again, I saw no need for. I have two children of my own. I wouldn't want my children playing with dolls of a slave master and a slave, etc. And it was marketed towards children. Here we have a toy that was sold with looses and things of that magnitude. It was just totally inappropriate. That was the reason why.
Was it marketed to kids, being that the movie was rated R, or was that something for adults to collect?
Well, the movie was marketed for adults, but the toys was marketed to kids. I understand they said that, well, this is a collector's item. That came out after we went national with our calls to pull them off. But the reality is, the toy was marketed for kids. I don't see too many adults playing with toys. Action figures.
So the dolls had nooses on them?
It had looses on them.
Well, the company put it out there basically that it wasn't geared towards kids, but the adults. But still, you know, the whole just thing behind it. I mean, it just really, it was over the top. And then the whole thing with people, you know, mentioning Inglourious Basterds and how they created action figures for Inglourious Basterds. Well, they only did two, and they did the two main people, but they did not. Another thing is, and this is a view from other people who responded to my change.org petition, they chimed in and they said, well, they didn't make Nazi dolls and they didn't make Holocaust dolls and, you know, other characters that were portrayed in Glorious Bastards. They didn't take it that far. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? So these were other people speaking out.
How many people signed your petition?
Over 19,000.
Wow.
And I was climbing. And then also, too, another thing is we had over 1,000 and something Facebook likes. And it was tweeted well over 100 and something times. And I didn't even get a chance to just dig in there and just, mm-hmm.
How long
know.
Did it take from the day that you started the petition to the toy company responded, or the movie company responded and put it off the shelf?
Exactly 10 days.
Mm.
And the night before, I was just bothered in my spirit. And I told Najee, I said, you know, and I reached out to him. I seen him on LinkedIn.
and I connecting with him the day before, and we ended up being Facebook friends. But the same night that we ended up being Facebook friends, and I seen my request, it was 3 in the morning, and just something was just not right in my spirit. I said, how can not, you know, our people respond more, and how can other people, other races, feel sorry for us and see the disrespect in it, and we not feel moved, but we could tweet about other things that mm-hmm. really don't, you know, I mean, like, make any sense on a day-to-day.
Cece, you brought up a good point that the dolls and the movies are two different things.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't seen the movie myself. I do want to see it. I'm a Quentin fan. Mm-hmm. Just haven't got around to it. If the movie is great and it has a great story, that's one thing. But mm-hmm. I can see how the dolls can be offensive just because of the trading aspect and the comments that people were making as far as, oh, I get to own a slave, and if these kids are playing with it, like, this is the, you know, slave owner type of thing. And that I can see why people would get upset about it, especially if it does get into the hands of children. And as we all know, you know, stuff like that do get in the hands of kids, regardless if they're marketed towards adults. Absolutely. If it's a doll, kids are going to be, you know,
I'm on the air right now,
trying to get towards it. And so I can see how it could be offensive. So I think it's two different things. I still want to see the movie.
Do you guys want to see the movie?
No.
Yeah, you know.
Do you want to see the movie?
It's on my to-do list.
What about you, Tenaya?
Not right now.
I'm looking at the dolls right now.
I love Tarantino, though. I love him.
Can we see the dolls?
I'm looking at the dolls right now, and I'm trying to bring it up on the screen. There's no noose anywhere.
All right, you have to. It's other pictures that's circulating that you will see the noose over.
Because we didn't even see a noose in the movie.
That's why we can understand why it was over his neck.
No, they had those. What were those things that the slaves were wearing around their necks with, like,
those are harness with the bells on them?
No. They were walking in the town, and they had, like, these rings around their neck, and then they had, like, these
wire things. Yeah, it's like a harness thing.
Yeah, that's slavery.
So they have that, right? Don't they have the harness?
They said there was talk with different people that were saying, like, you know, the comments from different people who are buying it, like, oh, cool, does it come with the welts on their back? Does it come with the chains on their legs? Does it come with a whip? You know, I want to be able to whip my slave, and all these different things. It's just horrible. I mean, I was like,
well, I know that there are people out there with that type of mentality. That's why we got on the bus and went to Jenna. So
that's why they bought the dolls too, boo. That's why they bought the
behavior is there.
They bought that because of that. They want to be able to share the experience. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And that's why it just needed to go. You know, why take it that far? You know,
what are you seeing now, Portis?
I'm not seeing a noose as previously described. I'm looking at the variations of dolls and the packaging, and I don't see that.
Well, again, we had plenty of pictures. I have some. I'll make sure I mail them to you if you can't find them on Google Images. Want to thank Tenaya for her activism, because of her activism and because of her voice. That story went caught on fire that Monday, and by that Friday, we received a major from TMZ broke the news that these dolls was taken off of the shelves or off of sales. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
One thing I will say about this is I think that the African American history is getting watered down. Mm-hmm. I do remember as a child being in elementary school, and Black history was an important part of history in the classroom. And I do think that the history is being forgotten. And when you look at the Jewish community, you can't forget the Holocaust.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not going to be watered down.
Oh, no.
So I do acknowledge the fact that the things that you're saying about the whips and let me whip. And then I even thought about what you said. If a kid gets that doll in his hand and the representation,
right,
just like you play with Ken and Barbie, you know, Ken and Barbie has the Corvette, they have the house. Mm-hmm. When you think of slavery, are the kids going to play master and slave owner and all that type of stuff?
Where's the plantation house? is that coming next? You know?
So at the least, I hope that this lets people know that slavery is not a joke. It shouldn't be taken lightly. Although I didn't walk away from that, from seeing Django. I walked away feeling like, you know, hearing a story about African Americans, they weren't all slaves. And they did they were intelligent.
Yes.
And that Caucasians weren't all bad, you know, and that...
No, they're not.
And, you know, and so I walked away with a lot, and I loved the love story. I'll never forget the name Broomhilda. You know, it was a great love story. So I love the movie. I understand what you're saying about the dolls, and we're going to take a quick break, and then we're going to come back and talk about that Oxygen show that was pulled. Let's take a listen to Mary Mary Dirt. You're tuned in to the Urban Post Worldwide Weekly Newscast on www.rmconair.com. That's fine. Oh.
Funny thing about a garden, beautiful.
listening to the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Yo, check it out. Check it out. Check it out.
Check it out.
With your host, Nielle.
Flyest mommy on the radio.
And her crew.
Turn up your radio.
Welcome back to the show. That was Mary Mary with Dirt. And they're doing big things right now. I just want to give a shout out to them and their husbands and the Soul Seekers for just doing great things. And I know Lamont has probably a little bit of that in his report. So let's go into the gospel report with the professor.
I'm sitting over here having problems with my headphones, but okay.
Hey, Lamont. Welcome back.
Happy New Year, everybody. And so much has been going on within the last month. The main thing is the Stellar Awards just happened this
past
Saturday.
And I had a chance to catch some of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It was actually live this year for 2 hours. And they actually did get a chance to actually play the entire show. So what they did was they did the 2-hour set. And then if you notice, the hosts were actually in the audience at the end doing the close and saying thank you for watching, but with this everything. And then there was a whole other hour that they did after that. Because you only get to see like 5 awards throughout the whole show, then the performances and everything. So what's going to happen is when they re-air everything throughout this whole month up until March 3rd, they're actually going to show like about 2.5 hours, 3 hours worth of footage and everything. So you'll be able to see everything. But the live show went off without a hitch. They didn't have too many problems and everything. So it came out okay.
Yeah, yeah. I was really blessed by Marvin Sapp.
Yeah.
He really ministered
and
to Tamela my soul.
And Tamela Mann killed. Oh,
I
my
missed
God.
Her.
Tamela Mann.
What did she sing?
Take Me to the King.
Okay. I like the other one. I don't
Which
know.
One?
The one about, she talks about you go through stuff. The you go through stuff, but. Her brother wrote the song.
Oh, the up-tempo song. I know which one you're talking about.
But and I enjoyed Israel.
Yeah, Israel was good.
And he and Jonathan Nelson.
Yeah.
That was a powerful song.
Yeah.
Israel always has an on-time
yeah.
word.
And you know what Ty Tribbett did the opening?
Uh-huh.
And one of his dancers hurt their foot during that performance. I thought I seen something, but he kind of, you know, shook it off and kept on dancing and everything, whatever. But the winners.
I have one more person I enjoyed. Donnie McClurkin and Marvin Winans.
That was good. And you know, speaking about Donnie McClurkin, he just lost his mom on Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was kind of real hard for him. And that's why they were kind of, you see the little delay a little bit? Marvin was like, he's coming out. We promise you he's coming out. Because they were actually kind of on the fence if whether or not he was going to do the song.
Wow.
But shouts out to Donnie McClurkin for going through it and doing the performance and everything and the loss of his mother.
Yes.
We're praying for him. They're going to be burying her on Saturday in New York, so yeah, definitely
keep him in the
definitely place. Best and worst dressed at the Stellars before I get to the awards.
Okay.
LeAndrea Johnson's purple and we don't know what it was, gray thing. Oh my God,
I didn't see that. I saw her red suit that she performed.
No, that was hot.
Okay,
but the dress that she had on before then when she accepted her award, ugh. Everybody's like, what in the world? Mary Mary's dress was a little off a little bit.
Which one? Tina's?
Yeah, Tina mostly. Tina mostly, but the beginning with Erica and the color of different shades and everything didn't really go with their hair color and things like that. So a lot of the press was talking about that. And then also, who was the other person? Kim Burrell had a little mishap in the back where one of the girls got loose in the midst of the press.
No.
It was not nice. She was
They say Kim is secular anyway.
She proved it that night.
I love Kim Burrell though, because she keeps it real.
And then James Fortune's wife had on some Versace shoes that all the ladies were trying to get. So,
oh, okay.
Yeah, she kind of wore her money that night. So, yeah, but getting to the actual awards, I don't know how many you want me to go through, like maybe the top 5 or something like that.
The ones that most people will know.
Okay, yeah. Artist of the Year, Marvin Sapp.
Yay.
Song of the Year, Charles Jenkins for Awesome.
Now, that is a powerful song. When he closed out at that song, when he kept taking it up higher and higher and higher, that was some church right there.
And then, actually, that actual project, I just got a chance to listen to the whole project on Monday. I, like, made it my booty. I said, it won CD of the Year, too. Mm-hmm. And I said, okay, I got to listen to it. That project is off the chain.
Andre Crouch looked a little disappointed when he won.
Well, so. I mean, let the church say, man, everybody's singing that in their churches now. So I think he thought that
was going to win,
too. I did, too. But...
But also then I felt the ministry of that song awesome when he sang it. There's something about, like, that's like a praise is what I do song.
Right.
It's something inside
it's
of it.
It's a little
it
more sentimental.
Just,
yeah.
And I had never heard of him before, so he's out of Chicago.
But you know what? He actually took over for Clay Evans. You remember Fellowship Church out of Chicago? Clay Evans and Follow the Ship, Stay on the Ship, back in the Malico days, Savoy days, had many projects out. Reverend Clay Evans, great speaker, preacher. He actually took over Fellowship.
Okay.
And so, like, three of the powerful churches that are out there now, Smokey Norfolk's Church in Chicago, then there's Bill Winston's church, Living Word, Donald Lawrence is the minister of music, and then there is Fellowship of Chicago, and so that's Fellowship of Chicago. That's their praise team slash choirs project, and Charles Jenkins is a pastor. So, yeah, shouts out to them. They actually took home 6 awards at the Stellars, and then Kiara Sheard won the Female Vocalist of the Year.
Now,
everybody was
that?
Like, "Wow!" Because I'm really applauding her because that's an independent project. You know, that's on Karen's label, Karoo Records. And so it's good that our indies are kind of getting out there. And her brother produced the project, too. So he's like an up-and-coming producer. So it went pretty good for them. Mary Mary, of course, got Group and Duo of the Year. New artist, Leandria Johnson.
Good for her.
Now, she's like the golden girl right now in gospel. It's like she can do no wrong. I mean, she's anointed and singing and everything. And everybody's kind of put that baby mama drama behind her, you know. And she's kind of stepping forefront. And she's got some great mentors like T.D. Jakes and Bishop Eddie Long that are helping her.
Bishop Eddie Long?
Shh.
What can he impart?
Hey, I don't
just
know.
Asking.
Well, you know, because she's in that Atlanta area, so you know,
there's a church on every corner.
I know, but he's one of her mentors, so.
Well, I guess you know.
I'm like salt and pepper when you think about it.
Bishop Eddie Long. I think I'd do church TV.
Yeah. Would you say TBN will be your home?
Or I'll just pop in my Marvin Sapp CD, you know?
Last thing is Isaac Carey, Gerald Haddon, Warren Campbell, they actually won Producer of the Year.
Didn't Gerald Haddon too?
Yes,
Gerald. Yeah, I called Gerald and asked him to be on the show today.
I did
too. He's not here.
What was the answer? Should we blast him like that?
Yeah, he didn't respond. And when I was on the radio,
he told me he'll
you
get
called
back to
me and I would put you on.
He said he's going to get back to us. So, Gerald, me and Niella, we waiting.
What's
really
Gerald.
Going on? We up the street.
You know,
that's
and we love Tammy. She can come do some praise and worship too.
Right. So, again, StellarAwards.com if you need to find out information about the air dates. I tried to get some, but they're not listed as of yet. Stellar Awards, what's up with y'all website? They're not listed, but we'll get the air dates. But it's from now to March 3rd. You can watch it in syndication. And again, they're going to be showing like a 2.5 hour, 3 hour show where they show the entire show and all the other awards. Also, I'm quite sure a lot of people are talking about the Dietrich Haddon and Demita Haddon drama that's going on right now.
You know, I've been reading his cryptic post. And it's just things that make you say, what's going on?
Well, I mean, I'm getting details on it. I don't really want to speak too
much. I love Dietrich Haddon, Sturdy
it.
Gift, that still ministers to me today, Brother Haddon.
Right, yeah. And you know what? Some of the most anointed people are some of, never mind. But
yeah, because you know, only people are drawn to testimony.
Yes.
So if you ain't never been through
nothing,
how
through
you
going to
tell me something? Yeah.
But alcoholism and baby mama drama and fornication, that's a little too much right now. I mean, it's like it's going rampant. And you know, he's saying that she slept with this person, he slept with that person.
He's getting married,
everything.
Right? He posted that he's engaged and he's found love.
He's engaged, he's found love, but that baby is 6 months. And so that means that you were doing stuff before your divorce was final and everything. It's a lot of drama going on. And then there was a fight at Demita's mom's house with the brother and him. So I'm getting some more details.
Do they have kids together?
No.
Demita and?
No. No. Oh. They was a little too busy to make any, but TLC's show.
Okay, and just so you know, Dietrich Haddon is famed for that song, God is Good. Remember that song, God is, okay. So
and Well Done, and
yeah, it might come to me.
Yeah, it was back in the day. It was maybe 5 or 6 years ago, but that was the biggest hit he had that was crossover, God is Good.
Yeah, but you know, he's got a new group called the League of Extraordinary Worshippers.
Oh, and the Sinner's Prayer. He was popular for the song, there it is, that one too.
Yeah, uh-huh. so he's got a new project coming out as well. But I'm going to get some details for next week's show and tell you all about the drama because I want to know about the fight. I just heard about the fight on the way here.
Oh, wow.
So, yeah, he tried to confront her and the brother came outside.
Let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
So.
And I want to talk about next week, Bishop Larry Trotter. We definitely need to talk about him. Not talk about him, but just inform our listeners as to the picture that he has floating around on the internet with him in the bathtub with his 3-year-old granddaughter, and they both look naked.
Oh my goodness.
Look naked. I mean, bubbles can't cover up everything.
Wait,
they are naked.
But I heard the interview. He did say that he got out the bathtub, put on his boxers, and put on some boxers on her, and then they got back in the bathtub because she came, the granddaughter came, and this is from his mouth.
Right.
I listened to the interview with him.
Right.
He said that the granddaughter came into the bathroom and said, granddaddy, whatever, why you got all them bubbles? You know, and I want to get in the bathtub. So he said he got out the bathtub, put on some drawers, put on some, the little girl had on her diaper, put him in, and the mama took the picture, and it ended up on Facebook.
Did somebody reach for a towel before he got out the tub?
And he said that it was an innocent
right,
act.
Right, did the bubbles dissipate?
He said it was innocent, and that he just can't believe the way that people are reacting to this.
By a show of hands, who all took a bath with their grandparent?
Well, I mean, as a child, though, I have bathed with my mother.
I'm going to tell you
something. I'm just saying. Back, as a child.
Yeah.
Yeah, but mama didn't take no pictures into a video camera of it, did
well,
she?
Well, we weren't in the world of Facebook and Instagram and everybody
We've been in
just,
the world of Instamatic cameras forever, but.
But where would you put that? In the paper?
I don't know.
You know, I just. It's a little odd.
Exactly. So I'm like, that's a little too much. I heard about it.
I heard him with his own mouth said that it was him.
And I heard he said it was innocent. They actually had on bottom clothing is what he said.
Well, Tanae and Cece are saying that if you see that picture, report it to www.asacp.org. But that is a great website because we are on Facebook a lot. And you see a lot of things that are just...
out for craziness.
Weird. So that's a great website. We're going to take a quick break. That is the Gospel Report. And then we're going to talk with Mo Kelly. He has reached the building. Yay! You're tuned in to www.rmconair.com. And we are the Urban Post Worldwide.
Yo, hip hop started out in the heart, yo. Not everybody trying to charge, say what? Hip hop started out in the heart, yo. Not everybody trying to charge.
Come on now, baby, come on now, baby, come on now, baby, come on. Come on now, baby, come on now, baby, come on now, baby, come on.
Come on, baby, light my fire. Everything you drop is so tired.
Everything.
Music is supposed to inspire. How come we ain't getting no higher? Now tell me your philosophy on exactly what an artist should be. Should they be someone with prosperity and no concept of reality? Now who you know without any flaw?
Who you know without any flaw?
That lives above a spiritual law.
That lives above a spiritual law.
And does anything they feel just because?
Feel small
makes you think you're unable to fall.
is so tired. Yeah. Music is supposed to inspire.
Why you beef with freaks as my album sells peak, huh? All I wanted was to sell like 500 and be a ghetto superstar since my first album blunted. I used to work at Foot Locker, they fired me in front it. Or I quit it, now I spit it. However do you want it, now you get it. Right and rhyme the range with the frames lightly tinted and send it to your block and have my full name submitted. And if your lines sound like mine, I'm taking a percentage. Unprecedented and still respected when it's vintage. I'm serious, I'm taking over areas in Aquarius. Running red lights with my 10,000 chariots. Jesus Christ was a superstar. You stupid star, they hail you, they nail you. No matter who you are, they'll make you now to take you down and make you face it. And if you slip the bag open, put your pinky in it to taste it.
Come on, baby, light my fire. Everything you drop is so tired.
Everything you drop, everything you drop.
Music is supposed to inspire. So how come we ain't getting no higher?
Worldwide Radio.
Yo, check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
Check it out.
With your host, Niel.
Flyest mommy on the radio.
And her crew.
Turn up your radio.
That was Lauryn Hill with Superstar. Just a little throwback from the miseducation of Lauryn Hill. Today, we've been talking about the power of one and how one individual can join with many and make change. So joining us now, Tenaya Jackson is still in the studio with us, along with CeCe Counts, who was able to make change and pull the Django dolls off the market that were being sold. And CeCe has been giving us information about how to stop child pornography on Twitter, on Facebook, and online. And Morris Kelly, who is the host of the Mo Kelly Report, which airs Saturdays from 6 to 8 on KFI, and XM 166 on Saturdays and Sundays from 8 to 9, is joining us right now. Hey, Mo.
Good afternoon. How you doing, ladies?
Hi. So now, how's the show going?
It's outstanding. And actually, I'm suffering from an embarrassment of riches because since there are so few African Americans in that space on talk radio, mm-hmm. it allows me the opportunity to discuss and address all sorts of issues that are not being addressed elsewhere, but I get all the attention. So
nice.
You know,
nice.
It's going well, to the short answer.
So as I was telling you about, we've been talking about the power of one, and you've been able to shed light to a lot of issues in the African-American community and at large. But one I want to talk about is all my baby's mamas.
Well, gladly, there's not a lot to discuss in the respect that I was a part of a coalition of individuals, and we moved forward to stop that program before it started. The very idea that our children were for sale was unacceptable. Mm-hmm. The fact that we're going to have these children literally strewn across the lawn mm-hmm. and put on display so people can make money off them, the dysfunction of a supposed family, was not acceptable. And so we hit the issue at the very beginning. So before
we can get Let's go back. So All My Baby's Mamas was a show that was supposed to come on the Oxygen Network.
Yes.
And so they began to release press around it.
They released a press release and this teaser trailer, which they said was stolen from them. Mm-hmm. And so people could get a sense of what the show was going to be about. It was mm-hmm. supposed to be a 1-hour special, but we all know that's going to lead into a full-blown show.
Mm-hmm. And so you saw this trailer and this press release and you said...
I said, hell to the no. And then I was contacted on Twitter by a woman by the name of Sabrina Lamb, who hit the ground running. Uh-huh. It was trying to aggregate as much media as possible to bring some sort of light to this issue. And we started strategizing and mobilizing and making sure that people knew about it before it got to air. Because when a show gets to air, it makes it much more difficult to get it off the air. Mm-hmm. Some people say that there's no such thing as bad press. That's not true. Mm-hmm. You can shame someone into doing the right thing. And that was our intent. And that's where
Sound
we succeeded.
Sound familiar, Tenaya?
Oh, yes. I reached out to her, too. She hit me back
there
on
you go.
She started the petition for the Jango doll. Oh, and that's how she hooked up with Najee and Reverend Tulloss, and they pulled it off. Yes.
There is power in being on the right side of the argument. Mm-hmm. You know, the truth is always more powerful than a lie.
That's right. That's right. So did you guys get a response from Oxygen personally, or did they just send out a generic press release? How did that go about?
There was a lot of communication in the back channels where they would send us, oh, thank you for your letter, but here is our statement from the president. And we were letting him know that this is just going to get worse before it gets better. So they weren't necessarily engaging us in direct conversation because they didn't think that we really could pull it off. Mm-hmm. And so they thought if they ignored it, it might go away, or at least that we would not be able to have the fortitude and the momentum to keep it going. And that's the thing. You have to endure and you have to have a coordinated strategy so people know that you're not just four or five individuals flailing your arms about.
And so how many signatures did you guys get?
Well, 38,000.
Wow. Mm-hmm. Wow. And so have you heard from Shawty? Shawty Lowe?
Last I heard, he was arrested a few days ago. He has started his own petition trying to get the show put back on or and on Rush the production slate.
And Rush Limbaugh is
supporting Shawty.
Yeah.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, good answer. Of course he is. And so what are your thoughts about that, Mr. Talk Radio?
Well, Rush Limbaugh is Rush Limbaugh, but he has no say in our community. He never will have a say. That is if we take ownership of the images and the media and what goes in our community. Such a show cannot be a hit unless we allow it to happen. If we don't allow it to happen, I don't give a damn what Rush Limbaugh says. Not on my watch.
That's right. Yes. Okay, so now, since we're talking about television shows, I just want to throw out a couple of reality shows, and you guys can chime in and just tell me petition, no petition. Basketball Wives Miami.
Is this petition, no petition?
Yeah.
We actually discussed this in our coalition. It's one of those things where we can't necessarily fight every negative stereotype out there. And that was the difference with Shorty Lowe, because it involved the exploitation of children, which made it very clear for people. And it's not necessarily we're giving a blank pass to the other shows such as Basketball Wives.
Love and Hip Hop.
Atlanta and so forth.
Well, no, you don't touch Atlanta.
Oh, one at a time?
No,
okay.
No, don't touch Atlanta.
Don't touch Atlanta?
No, I love Atlanta.
Oh, God. Oh,
no, actually, let me just say this. I do watch the Basketball Wives series. Mm-hmm. Pretty much, I love the Beverly Hills. Mm-hmm. I love the basketball, L.A. and Miami. Mm-hmm. You know, I do watch them, but I get what you're saying. I'm going to stick with you when you say when you bring the kids in it, then it's definitely a no-no.
Yeah.
Well, I think the more comparison, then we would go into the Honey Boo Boo type of situation, and then even the toddlers and tiaras, as far as exploiting these kids and having them look like adults, pretty much, you know, and dolled up and in these swimsuits and you know, prancing around on the stage like they're adults. That goes into, you know, what I was, that's just like the training ground for kids to get into, you know, making it feel okay at a young age to be like that. So then when a predator comes around and makes them feel good, they're an open book for them.
Mm-hmm. So, do you think now with the reality TV shows being so prominent on television and taking the place of, you know, sitcoms and dramas, do you think that there does need to be a coalition or watchdog organization to monitor these shows and be able to be like that advocate between the networks and the public?
I think
they have those type of things in different industries. Do you think now is the time in television to have that people coalition to work with networks to say what is morally or ethically right?
Well, I don't know about all of that because of, you know, creative reasons. You know, I know that definitely
First Amendment right, freedom of expression.
And you want to, you know, have a little bit in there. But as far as I say, where are the actors and the actresses that want to, you know, still have a job I mean, if you're going to hire...
They're complaining about reality TV.
Yeah. I'm like, what happened to the...
Stars,
yeah, the real shows, the development, and the whole nine. Like, I missed that, you
know? It's about money, unfortunately, because it's cheaper to give somebody who hasn't crafted anything or, you know, they're the everyday person, and you throw them, you know, $5,000 per episode opposed to $100,000 per episode to somebody who skilled their craft, and you don't have a big production, you know, that you have to set up.
It's more editing than acting.
Yeah, and that way, you know,
yeah,
it's the mighty dollar.
But there are regular people out here, you know, that aren't, you know, in the industry, and they have families and stuff like that, and they want to see real shows develop. They miss that content, you know.
I think it's starting to come back a little bit. Mm-hmm. I think that people are starting to see it a little bit more. I think I would like to see the time schedules go back to the way they used to be, because it is a fine line between freedom of speech. But remember when a crazy show or something that was showing any type of sexual content or anything like that didn't come on until like
after 9 o'clock or 10 o'clock.
Uh-huh. I mean, now you're seeing these shows, you know, at 5 o'clock, 4 o'clock, when, you know, the kids are getting off at school. Yes, they can still, you know, access it online, and there's so many avenues that they can get to it. But, you know, at least put a little bit more guidelines on it, mm-hmm. so it makes it a little bit more difficult, because when we start accepting it as the norm, we mm-hmm. become numb to stuff that we should not accept. And that goes, you know, back Absolutely. To the child pornography on Facebook that we saw. We got so numb to seeing, you know, pornographic stuff on Facebook, you know, pop up here and there, you know, half naked girls, whatever, that I don't want it to get to the point where it's just normal for us. Mm-hmm.
And it's becoming that way.
And it's becoming normal. So it's a very, very fine line. But I think that guidelines are definitely something that we need, because if we didn't have guidelines in life, period, whether it was laws, life in general would be a mess. We'd like to think that everybody is a good person, so mm-hmm. we shouldn't give you a rule.
Mm-hmm.
But we need rules.
Yeah. That's what the FCC is, rules. Right?
Absolutely. You got to have guidance. Boundaries. You got to have parameters and guidelines.
Yeah, but it's going to take the people to... get passionate about some things. That's why we're talking about the power of one. Yesterday, President Obama announced Organizing for Action, which is the next extension of how he plans to lead the country. But I think it's a great example of how individuals can make change. That's why I'm so grateful and thankful for you guys to be here today, because you guys are organizing for America and organizing for action by, you know, being your brothers and sisters' keeper, mm-hmm. caring about the child.
That's right.
You know, preserving history and tired of seeing baby's mama drama.
Got enough of that.
Yes. So thank you guys for coming. As I said, you always have an open invitation here. And, you know, whenever you want to talk about a petition or something that the community needs to know about, the Urban Pulse is always welcome to you.
Thank you, Neil.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Neil.
You're welcome. Coming up, Tremaine has the main squeeze, so we're going to probably hear about what they're saying about Beyonce in this inauguration Star Spangled Banner. Hopefully, we're going to hear about the Super Bowl and a whole lot of other stuff. You're tuned in to the Urban Pulse Worldwide Weekly Newscast on www.rmconair. Here's R. Kelly with I Wish.
To every city,
I wish,
every hood,
I wish,
and every block, ghetto America.
I wish.
Rolling through the hood, just stop by to say what's up, and let you know your baby boy ain't doing so tough. And even though you've passed going on for long years, still waking up late at night crying tears. Just thinking about those days you used to talk to me, smiling while I'm sipping on this Hennessy. And remember we'd brag on how rich we would be, to get up out this hood was like a fantasy.
And now you hear my songs, the radio is banging.
Oh, I can't believe my ears and what everybody's saying. Boy, I tell you, folks don't know the half. I would give it all up just to take one ride
with you.
How I used to kick it on the front porch
with you.
How I used to lay back and smoke weed
with you.
And all the little basement party joints we do. Now I'm just missing you. How I wish that I could hold you now.
Oh,
I wish that I could touch you now.
Oh,
I wish that I could talk to you, be with you somehow.
I know
you're in a better place.
Oh,
even though I
stress. Sometimes I wish that I could just trade in my success. Y'all look at me and say, boy, you've been blessed. But y'all don't see the inside of my unhappiness. Man, I swear it gets heavy like a ton. That's why you hear me shooting this real off like a gun. I wonder how my friends would treat me now if I wasn't iced up with a Bentley and a house. That's why fake niggas get fake digits and fake players get a real player hating them. Honey, love goes platinum and y'all it's come around. But y'all don't wanna raise the roof until my theater's going down.
My songs, the radio is playing.
Oh, I can't believe my ears and what everybody's saying. Boy, I tell you, folks don't know the half. I would give it all up just to take one ride.
How
I used to hoop off in them tournaments. How I used to club hop on weekends.
With you.
Your family called the morning of a tragic end. Damn, my condolences. I wish that I could hold you now.
Oh,
I wish that I could touch you now.
Oh,
I wish that I could talk to you. Be with you somehow.
Oh, I know.
Head be telling me to come to church. Said the Lord is the only way for you to stop the hurt. Dreaming of windows black tinted like a hearse. Waking up to life sometimes seems worse. And all I ever wanted is to be a better man. And I try to keep it real with my homies, man. Want me to save the world, I don't understand. How did I become the leader of a billion
fans?
Oh, I can't believe my ears and what everybody's saying. Boy, I tell you, folks don't know the half. I would give it all up just to take one ride. How I used to street perform on Friday. And how I'd go to church on Easter Sunday. Instead of y'all throwing them stones at me, somebody pray for me.
Oh, I wish that I could hold you now.
Whoa.
The Worldwide Entertainment Report.
Oh my God.
It's going down.
What's up? This is Rihanna.
What up, y'all? It's your man Tyrese.
This is Cat Williams.
This is Mariah Carey, and you're listening to
the Urban Post Worldwide Radio.
Holla at you, folks.
Hey. Tremaine's in the building. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
So what you got for us today?
Oh, my goodness. Lord, we've been on a break for a month. There is so much going on in this entertainment world.
What is it?
So much. Not too much to talk about. But
well, you're going to talk about it,
oh,
right?
Oh, we're going to talk about some things.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, definitely. So first, Lifetime is bringing us Betty and Coretta, a movie about the friendship between Malcolm X's wife, Betty Shabazz, and Martin Luther King Jr.'s wife.
Nice.
Coretta Scott King. The story is about how their bond formed and grew through the civil rights movement after both of their husbands were assassinated, and they continue fighting for the causes that their husbands died for.
Nice.
Angela Bassett is playing Coretta Scott, and Mary J. Blige will be playing Betty Shabazz.
Wait, wasn't it the opposite in the movie? Who did you say is playing Coretta Scott?
Angela Bassett.
Didn't she play Betty in Malcolm X?
She did. She did.
Okay, I'm just checking.
They switched it up. Malik Yoba will be playing Dr. King, and Lindsay Owen Pierre will be playing Malcolm X. You can catch the premiere February 2nd.
Nice, okay.
Yeah.
Just like I saw that Jennifer Hudson's playing Winnie Mandela.
Yeah.
Why?
She is.
No, yeah. Winnie Mandela. Bella. She's actually playing Winnie Mandela. I saw the trailer and she looked in character.
She looked like Winnie,
yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, she really did.
She's a new character. She's going to be in the TV show Smashed.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Oh, awesome. Awesome.
Yes.
Barbara Walters is recovering after an inauguration weekend fall. She is expected to be released from the hospital soon. Whoopi Goldberg said today on The View, Walters fell Saturday on a stair at the British ambassador's residence and out of an abundance of caution was taken to the hospital to be examined by doctors. Mm-hmm. Barbara went to Washington to cover the inauguration. She missed a step and had a fall, which cut her upper temple, and doctors stitched up, and she is doing fine, but she's taking it easy.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So good luck. Get well. A couple of weeks ago, Lindsay Lohan made the worst decision of her life. She fired Sean Holly, the lawyer that kept her out of jail multiple times, and hired a New York lawyer, Mark Heller, who was suspended from practicing law for about 5 years back in 1994.
I am so ready for her just to get locked up.
She does.
So after, maybe this is why.
Yeah.
She needs to go to jail.
She does. But
it's been a long time coming.
Girlfriend TMZ reported today that Lohan rejected an offer from Dancing with the Stars. Yes.
That's probably good for us, the viewer.
It's good for us, but it's not good for her and her pocketbook. They offered her $550,000 to learn some dances and dance in front of a television audience. And due to her ego, she has said no. She wants to stick to movies and not reality TV.
Okay, enough of Lindsay.
Yeah. So Lance Armstrong, formerly the cycling's most decorated champion and considered one of America's greatest athletes, confessed to cheating for at least a decade, admitting on Thursday that he owed all seven of his Tour de France titles and the millions of dollars in endorsements that followed to his use of illicit drugs. Due to that, the USADA findings found Armstrong wrong, of course, mm-hmm. and stripped him of all his titles.
Well, yeah, we knew that, yeah.
Which should have happened. And, of course, all of his endorsement deals have gone away. Nike, one of his biggest endorsers, left him.
Yeah.
Don't they want their money back, too?
I would expect everybody to want their money back.
Right.
Yeah, they're saying that it hasn't come out yet, but there are going to be some people who want. Nike actually did a commercial taking dibs at, you know, the allegations that were against him mm-hmm. because they believed in his innocence. So we'll see.
We'll see.
But
we'll
good
see.
For Oprah. That really helped the network.
I really want
for OWN to succeed. And definitely kudos to Oprah.
Oh, yeah. She got some big viewership. The first episode brought in about 3.3 million viewers. The second one didn't do as good. It brought in about 1.1 million viewers.
Yeah.
She's getting ready to do LL Cool J, right? Mm-hmm. This weekend. I've seen the promo for that. It looks like it's going to be good. He's going to be talking about the break-in.
You know, break-in?
The guy that broke in his house.
Oh, the one he beat up?
He beat up. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Yeah.
Mama said knock you out.
Do you hear?
Now, there was a lot going on with Obama's inauguration. Not specifically with his inauguration, but a lot of things just happening during that and Martin Luther King's Day. Alexandra Wright, baby mama to Matthew Knowles, claims that she received a letter from Papa Knowles back in September 2011.
What does this have to do with the inauguration?
Well, just the fact that it happened yesterday. It doesn't have anything to do with it, but it happened yesterday. The letter said, "You hurt my family, there's a price to pay." So she's worried that their 2-year-old son that they have together, Nixon, is in danger. Interestingly enough, she wants Matthew himself to up his $12,000 a month child support payment to cover a secure private school.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Lupe Fiasco created a bit of a ruckus on Sunday by insulting President Obama during an inaugural event. Fiasco was booked as one of the headliners for Startup Rock On concert in celebration of Obama's reelection. He had no plans to cheer the current administration. Instead, after taking to the stage at the Hamilton in Washington, he reportedly announced that he didn't vote for President Obama in the 2012 election and spent more than 30 minutes performing an anti-war song. After the rant, he was escorted off the stage.
I'm just... Why go? Why participate?
Exactly.
You know what you're there for.
Gimmick.
I mean, release the song if that's how you feel. Freedom of speech. But why at an Obama event?
Right.
Just
trying to stay relevant.
Okay.
Now, inauguration performance recaps. There were four divas that stood out to me. Of course, one was Beyonce, who performed the Star Spangled Banner, looked flawless, sounded flawless. Today, people are saying that she lip-synced the whole thing. Personally, from what I saw, what I heard, no.
No, it's true. She did lip-sync.
How?
The military band that played, the director said that she decided at the last minute.
He just wants some fame.
No. This is not uncommon. It's not a bad thing.
It's not
that when the public... how it's presented to the public. Now, if they would have said 80% of the people lip sync, they'd record the track the day before and then they decide whether they want to lip sync or not because it's cold outside, it's early in the morning, you know, she's preparing for the Super Bowl, her vocals. There's so many things. So it's not a bad thing if she did. It was still her voice.
Right.
It was a single track.
She killed. She killed.
It's not a bad thing.
You know. No, it's not a bad thing.
No.
Girl, I know you did that for real.
Yeah, she was.
I like to think that.
She was superb. She looked impeccable.
Oh, of course.
She played her role.
She did.
And everybody wants those emerald earrings now. Everybody.
And that ring.
Yeah.
And her Destiny's Child hairdo.
Well, they have knockoffs at Claire's. Next.
Hello. Kelly Clarkson, who performed America, My Country, Tis of Thee.
They say she sung live.
Yes, she did.
Sung live. You could definitely tell that was live.
Yeah.
Alicia Keys with her remix for Girl on Fire with Obama on Fire.
She was jamming. Keys, and she sung It's a New Day. She was really good. And she looked great as
she
well.
She did. Yeah. She did. And then Jennifer Hudson with Al Green's Let's Stay Together.
No, she got mixed reviews on that.
She did. I thought she did a great job, but...
a lot of people had a problem with...
Where was Al?
I get that, but... I understand. I'm
Al's
sorry.
In Europe. He's in Europe on tour.
But he would have came.
So he couldn't have been.
Okay. He would have came.
Eddie got word.
But here's the deal to me with the Obamas. They keep it real.
Yes.
That's your Chi-Town.
Right.
Superstar.
Right.
You know, and there's some heartfelt compassion for everything that Jennifer's been through. She is the homegirl Southside.
Right.
Michelle is the homegirl Southside.
Right.
They're representing for their state.
Okay. Right.
That's how I received it.
Yeah.
And I got it.
Yeah.
I got it.
It was mixed though. It had its good points and its bad points.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it wasn't Beyonce's at last. I mean, excuse me, Etta James.
But the symbolicness of it, you know, he sung the song. He says he always sings it to Michelle. It was fitting and appropriate.
Yes.
All the way around.
Yeah.
Yes. Tomorrow is the season premiere of Unsung, which airs at 6 p.m. The focus tomorrow will be Isaac Hayes.
Okay.
Yes.
Shaft, right?
Shaft.
Yeah. Okay. And they got a lot of stuff coming up, too. They got Mint Condition and... Johnny Gill and a couple others this season. It's a good season coming up.
Now in the music world, this one I love. Real Housewives of Atlanta, Kenya Moore.
And Twirl.
Yes, has released. She's jumped on the Bravo's Housewives singers train and released Gone with the Wind, Fabulous.
And Twirl.
It's kind of a mess, but it grows on you. I saw her lot. She did it live for
Andy.
I actually liked it.
And when she fell out on the floor, I'm like, Kenya is just over
now,
top madness.
She could have had some more help with that. I'm sure she knows more gay people that can fall the way she needed to fall.
or choreography.
Well, I mean, you know, she's doing her thing. She's doing her thing.
Fantasia, Loose Twin, great song. Many people can definitely relate to that. Destiny's Child has teamed up and released Nuclear. The title of the album is Love Songs, which is slated for January 29th. Donnell Jones has dropped a new single titled Forever and has an album slated for May.
Okay.
Tamar Braxton pushed back her album to March instead of February. And the New Kids on the Block just announced today on The View that they are going to be kicking off their 2013 summer tour with 98 Degrees Boy and Boys to Men.
Now, I wonder if Justin Timberlake, now they did mention his name today on The View, but he wasn't there today. Nope. So I'm interested to see if he's going to show up for some of those
and I
dates.
I love his new single.
It would be nice if he would. Don't forget Humble Beginnings. Humble Beginnings.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Don't
very
forget
true.
Where you come from, partner.
So they'll be at the Staples Center July 5th to perform. So you can check them out.
And then Boys and Men is at, they're at the hotel now in Las Vegas.
Oh, they're at a hotel. Well, they're going on tour with 98 Degrees. And
Right. Yeah, but they're actually starting to do they're actually set to do a couple of years. No, they're doing a couple of years at the Mirage in Las Vegas. They announced that too.
And last but not least, Atlanta rapper turned actor T.I. is looking for a $75 million record deal. Sony is said to have offered already $50 million contract, and a meeting is scheduled with Universal. T.I. is also in talks with Dr. Dre and Jay-Z's Roc Nation. The deal reportedly includes an exclusive signing of all Grand Hustle artists. In addition, Tip supposedly wants three albums under the contract and corporate endorsement deals, along with 10 to 20% of all publishing, merchandise, and touring.
Wow, I like T.I. though. So, yes. I mean, hey.
Yes.
Do it. All right, is that it?
That's it.
All right, I have a couple of stories to add to that before we check out the Super Bowl. It's being framed as Ray Lewis and the Tale of Two Brothers. San Francisco 49ers and Baltimore Ravens are going to be in the Super Bowl that is taking place February 3rd. Kickoff is scheduled for approximately 3:30 Pacific Standard Time. It's going down at the New Orleans Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Halftime show performance is Destiny Child and Beyonce. And the national anthem will be sung by none other than Miss Alicia Keys. Now, this is airing on CBS, and ticket prices right now are averaging $3,195.14.
Nice.
The 2013 Sundance Film Festival kicked off Thursday, January 17th in Park City, Utah, and the festivities will run through January 27th. Already there being snapped, Alicia Keys and Jennifer Hudson right before they flew back to D.C. for their inauguration. And then finally, what do I want to let you know? I want to let you know that if you are still worried about catching that flu, Help Remedy says it has a powerful tool for keeping the flu at bay. It's called Help I Have the Flu, and it's a Facebook app that scans through your Facebook page to identify whom among your social network is most likely to give you the flu. That way you can stop hanging out with them before it's too late. So just Google Help Remedies, and the app is called Help I Have the Flu. And then finally, just a historic note about yesterday. President Barack Obama says it was a privilege to take the oath of office using the Bible that had been owned by the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. And Obama also took the oath on two Bibles, Dr. King's Bible and Abraham Lincoln's personal Bible. So yesterday was a beautiful day. Nice. That's your news. That's your entertainment. That's your information. We hope you have been enlightened, informed, and empowered today. I want to thank Tremaine.
Thank you.
Welcome back.
Good to be back.
Professor, welcome back. We have a lot in store for you this year. I want to thank Portis for always holding us down. And that'll do it for today. So we'll check you out next week right here at the Urban Post Worldwide. And you can always find us at www.rmconair.com. And we're going to close out with none other than Big Biz Marky with Vapors.
Radio, TV, and even the press say what's the meaning of V-A-P-O-R-S. The meaning of this word, without no doubt, means nobody wanna beat that one you're down and out. Now when you're established and got a lot of money, everybody wanna be your buddy and honey. Like tall buildings they call skyscrapers. Can you feel it? Nothing can save ya, but this is the season of catching the vapors. And since I got time, what I'm gonna do is tell you how they spread it throughout my crew.